Hello. Have you ever wanted to create a Rovo agent that is able to utilize data from a custom data source? Or maybe one that includes some sort of logic that is easier to code than to describe in a prompt? Or maybe you want to sell your agent in Atlassian's marketplace? If so, this is where building agents using Forge can help. Forge is Atlassian's development platform that makes building and running apps easy. Okay, so let's take a look at the agenda. We'll start by taking a look at some of the basic concepts of Rovo agents. We'll just be using the out-of-the-box capabilities during this stage. We'll then go and create a Rovo agent. We'll dig into the details of some of the code to explain how that agent works. We'll then take a look at some of the more advanced concepts of Rovo agents and the code, because some concepts may not be completely obvious if you're exploring this on your own. And finally, I'll provide some resources to help you go on and create Rovo agents on your own. So what are Rovo agents? You can think of them as customizations of Rovo's AI capabilities that are designed to perform specific kinds of tasks. The goal is to help users move work forward by utilizing Rovo's natural language capabilities. Rovo agents are useful for many kinds of text-heavy processing where there is some kind of pattern to the work that needs to be performed. But perhaps the best way to think of Rovo agents is as virtual teammates.
Have you met the newbie? How does he know so much about everything? It's his first day.
Yeah, he's amazing. He just wrote a blog post for me. It was brilliant.
It was nothing.
So, I need to write a job description for a new role on my team. And we'll need interview questions for the candidates.
Done and done.
Wait, what?
We need to revise taglines and build social posts for the new campaign.
Be right back. Okay. Drop some ideas for those in the chat.
Okay.
You should make sure that code doesn't introduce any security risks. Like this.
Boom. Thanks, newbie.
Hey. Wait, there's more newbies?
Yeah, there's lots of them. And they help us get things done much faster.
Wow, we're ready to launch 3 months ahead of schedule. How's that even possible?
The newbies. Couldn't have done it without them.
Without who?
Here's a conceptual overview of Rovo. Rovo leverages Atlassian intelligence capabilities to provide AI processing on customer data. Internally, this data is organized with lots of relationships between the data, which we collectively call the teamwork graph. Rovo agents can be configured to focus on specific areas of this data to avoid being distracted by irrelevant information. There are two broad types of Rovo agents, but note that many will exhibit characteristics of both types. Time-saving agents often involve distilling and organizing data. Agents focused on quality improvements typically involve manipulating information into new forms. Rovo includes a wide variety of predefined agents ready for use. Users can browse through these agents to discover the ones that will help with their workflows. This is also where the Rovo agents built with Forge show up. There are a number of locations within Jira and Confluence where users can use Rovo agents. The chat sidebar is where you can have an interactive conversation with an agent. When editing a Jira issue description or Confluence page, you can use Rovo to help craft the content. And agents can also be used in automation rules. Rovo provides a chat experience that allows users to have interactive conversations with Rovo's AI. Start by asking a question or entering an instruction, and continue to build on the conversation with further questions and instructions. Agents are often configured with conversation starters. These are initial questions or instructions which show up in the UI and can be selected to simulate the start of a conversation. Every agent has a prompt. This is where the behavior of the agent is defined. Good prompts define aspects such as the agent's goals, character, knowledge sources, and actions that the agent can take. Prompt engineering is a skill which takes practice. It's like coding, but instead of using traditional coding languages like JavaScript, the code is in natural language. Okay, so now we're going to create an agent with Forge. But first, why would you want to when you can create agents directly in Jira and Confluence? There are a few reasons, such as the ability to augment the agent with logic in the Forge app, connect to bespoke data sources, keep the prompt of your agent private, and distribute your agent in the Atlassian marketplace. This diagram illustrates the relationship between Forge agents and Rovo. Forge agents define the prompt and other aspects, such as the conversation starters, just like regular agents, but they can also define actions that Rovo invokes during the processing of AI requests. These actions typically involve making API calls to manipulate data or to retrieve data for the AI to operate on. To create a new Forge app that provides a Rovo agent, simply enter Forge Create into the Forge CLI and then select the Rovo Agent template. Your agent will then be created within a few seconds. After creating the app, you need to deploy it using the Forge Deploy command. Then you need to install the app into a workspace using the Forge Install command. After installing the app, any further changes to it requires a redeployment using the Forge Deploy command again, so the overall development workflow looks a bit like this. To test the app's agent, open the Rovo agent using the Browse Agents UI and select it. Given it's an agent you're developing, you'll probably want to click the agent's star icon to make it a favorite so that you don't have to find it next time using the Browse Agents UI. Either click one of the conversation starters or enter a specific question or instructions to invoke it. Okay, so let's take a look at some of the code that was created. The app's manifest contains a lot of the app's definition, including the agent. Expanding the Rovo Agent module section, we can see various aspects such as the agent's name, description, and prompt. The prompt is where you will typically need to spend most of your time, as it can get quite complex. The Rovo Agent module is also where the conversation starters are defined. The agent's prompt can reference actions that Rovo must invoke in order to manipulate or retrieve data. A single agent can utilize multiple actions. Actions are like functions in traditional programming languages. Each action can define inputs that Rovo must provide when it is invoked. In this particular case, the input is a message that the user is requesting to log. Inputs are like function parameters in traditional programming languages. The title and the description of each input is for Rovo's benefit and won't be displayed to users. Rovo matches the user's request with the prompt to work out how to fill out the action inputs. It's a bit like magic, but one important tip is to be consistent with your terminology. Each action specifies an action verb, which describes what kind of operation it can perform. Note that the message logger app should probably use the trigger action verb rather than get. To avoid potentially problematic scenarios, automation rules won't invoke actions defined with either the create, update, or delete action verb. To create a good prompt, make sure you define what the role of the agent is, the job it needs to perform, and any additional context necessary to focus on the correct outcome. A simple example illustrating all three aspects is as follows. Role: you are a content marketing writer. The job: your job is to help people generate ideas for marketing assets and blogs, like social media posts. Here are a few guidelines to help with your agent creation. As with previous guidelines, they equally apply to user-defined agents and forge agents. Most of the guidelines boil down to ensuring the agent is defined as clearly and unambiguously as possible. If your agent becomes too complex, it will probably suffer from reliability issues, so you should probably look for ways to split it into multiple agents. Also, make sure you test your agent with a wide range of scenarios. Additionally, make sure you design your agent so that it can be used in different contexts, or at least it is clear what context it's supposed to be used in. When using the agent in a chat context, how does it behave when the user is viewing a Jira board versus a Jira work item? Does the agent work in the editor? What happens if the agent is included in an automation rule? When an agent's action is invoked, the payload provided to the action contains identifiers like an issue key, which can be used to work out what the current context is. Most importantly, you should test your agent in all these situations. Creating Rovo agents with Forge is a pretty amazing kind of app development. You can accomplish a lot with a small amount of code, but being a relatively new kind of technology, there is still a lot for us all to learn. Good luck with your development. I'll be interested to see how you get on.